We had to wait on our days for when the weather moderated so we didn't create more stress. And then the cows are on both sides of this pasture so they can touch noses. And since we didn't have anybody in this other pasture in here, we did receive 5.5 inches of rain in August, where June and July was only about an inch.
Uh-huh.
Both months, and that was if you add up to 1/10 and 2/10. So I don't know that
didn't help a whole lot.
Watering the grass.
Well, 2012 started off as a dry year and has stayed dry throughout the state of Iowa. A number of us were talking about the dry weather and watching the drought monitor and kind of keeping an eye out on the progress long before we ever started to call it a drought or to realize that it was in a full-blown drought. So I think we were very prepared when it really developed. But once it really did hit the drought, we were ready to take some action. And one of the first things was to put together some webinars statewide that addressed different topics related to producers, thinking that that was one way we could get a lot of information to a lot of producers in a short time period. Statewide, about 78 different meetings happened from mid-July until early September, and over 5,300 producers attended those programs. So again, very well attended. That drought has definitely affected our ability to raise crops, both corn and soybeans, which is our major cash crop and feed, but also our forages and our pastures. And because of that impact on pastures and hay and our future feed of corn, it's had a huge impact on our livestock producers, particularly cattle and hog producers.
You can see that they still got water down there.
It's holding out on this end at least.
So far. Well, the issue is we only got an inch of rain in June and an inch of rain in July, so the grass didn't grow, so we pulled about 75% of the cows up here to the place and hayed them for over 2 months. We're gonna have to have extra feed supply for this winter because last year we had pasture clear up to the first of the year, so stockpiled grass, and it's not gonna happen this year.
So this is your second year of growing winter rye?
Yes.
As a cover crop?
Yes, so we pastured early. We use it for early pasture last spring, so
okay.
if we get some rain, so our rye can take off.
But it looks like you have a halfway decent stand here, as dry as it's been. One of the other options that we posed to producers, and Wayne took us up on that, was the idea of cover crops. The use of cover crops behind our chopped corn has multiple assets. It conserves the soil, it'll help to catch some of the snowfall that we have this winter, but it also gives us an additional feed resource for either late this winter grazing or next spring grazing, so it gives us feed that way. Throughout the drought and all the programs we've done as we've reached over the thousands of producers, Extension and Outreach is here to help people. We're here for Wayne and Kathy. We're not here for the cattle or for the crops, but we're here for the farmers that we work with. That's what makes this job fun and exciting and a challenge to go to work every morning.